Hey guys, welcome back to part 3 of this video series. This one's gonna be really, really simple. It's just showing some simple exhaust using some simple deformers, and we're gonna be creating a mat out of this to use in After Effects. So this is a much simpler approach to a particle system with a lot less functionality, but it's so fast to render. So if that sounds interesting, let's get started. All right, so this next part, we're gonna do some exhaust. So if we look at the back of the plane here, inside the engines, there are two little cylinders here that you could use as emitters if you wanted to use a particle system. And particle systems are the way to go most of the time, but in this case, our plane is just flying in a straight line. In fact, it's actually not moving at all. It's just, we will make it look like it is moving just with the camera angle, and we could also move the environment slightly if we wanted to. So instead of using a particle system, we're just gonna make some geometry and then use the rendered silhouette as a mat for use in After Effects. So what we can do to begin with here, we can add a cube. Snap this over here, holding down the V key. Go into the settings for the subdivisions width and height, we can do 4. And then for the depth, we can do 100. Then I'm going to hold down the D key and the V key simultaneously and just reposition the pivot point to the edge of this object. And then I can just scale it out. And we can have this go pretty far. Might be a little bit large. I'll lower this down a little bit. Thing like this. And next, what we can do is flare this out at the end, because exhaust is going to dissipate as it flies through the air. We're going to first delete the history. So that is under Edit, Delete by Type History. I'm using a custom panel. So now we're going to go over to Deform, and we're looking for Non-Linear, and we'll click Flare. So with Flare, you get this axis. So holding down the J key, we're going to just snap this in place. And then go to the attribute, and then the end flare control, we're going to increase this quite a bit. We might do something like 4 and 4, so it makes it a bit wider. Next, what we're going to do, we're going to add another deformer, and this one is going to be a texture deformer. Now, on the texture deformer, if you go to the option box, there are several ways you can do this. One is UVs, and if we actually look at the UVs right now, the UVs are not very ideal. They're not in proportion, so we want to go up and just do like an automatic map, and then they'll be in proportion. I'm going to close that down, and then on the texture deformer, click create. And a texture deformer allows you to add your own texture into this, but I'm just going to add in some noise. Add in some noise, and by default, it's going to give you a very, very crazy result. If we back out, we can go to the strength and just lower the strength. And then if we go back to the input connection, we can increase the frequency ratio, and we can also do things like lowering the amplitude or changing the type. Billow is pretty good, wispy is good. These are all pretty useful. I'm just going to leave mine on billow. And what we want to do is animate this time function right here. And how to do that is just right click, create a new expression. I'm going to copy this attribute here, paste, and we'll just set that equal to time and then click create. So if we scrub forward, it's always going to oscillate back and forth. So this looks pretty good, but it is flat on one side. So we want to change that. Select the object and either go to the texture deformer here, or you can access it in the outliner as well. And we need to change the direction from handle to normal, and that will allow it to go out in both sides. We're also going to click the 3 key to smooth that out. And what we've got is some pretty simple looking exhaust that we can use. If you wanted to do more with that flare, it's also possible to do that. We could make it a little bit tighter at the beginning. It fits better into the engines, something like that. Okay, so to get the other side, what I want to do is go up to Edit, Duplicate Special. Make sure the option box is checked. This will allow any connections to be preserved, and click duplicate. Next, we're going to select the copy of the handle and the texture deformer, the new one, and we're just going to move them over. Just something like this. So to make these not exactly the same, we'll select the second one, go into the texture of the texture deformer. On this expression, we can edit that expression. You'll notice that the expression is now slightly different. This is number 4 instead of what it was before. Add a value to this and click OK. So don't worry if it's a little bit sharp. We're only using this as a mat, so we're only looking at the silhouette that this shape provides. All right, guys, hope you enjoyed this little tutorial. You can apply the same concept to lots of different things. So if you learned something, drop a like. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment. Otherwise, I'll see you in the next video. Peace.